ahead and get started. Thanks everyone for coming out for session after lunch. Welcome back. My name is Joshua Silver, and I head up product development for a local company here in town called Patientco. It's my privilege to be here today talking about some technical product development management topics. Just a quick show, poll for the audience. Why did everyone come? What are you guys hoping to learn today? Anyone just throw something out? Okay, so you're interested a little bit more about what it is. What else? Anyone have any other? What's that? See if we do things differently, all right? Anything else? I'm sorry? Estimations. Okay, yeah, we'll talk a little bit about that. Anything else? Anyone else? Anything else that people are hoping to learn today? Yep. Great. All right. Well, with that, we'll kind of jump into it. So, this is the agenda for today. I'm going to talk just a quick little bit about my background and how I kind of got into technical product development management. I'm going to talk a little bit about the differences as you transition from development over into more of a product management role, how your mindset needs to shift a bit. And even if you're not making a formal shift over from a job perspective, how you can incorporate some of that thinking into your everyday development tasks. I'm going to talk, in my mind, you can really boil product management down to two simple functions. There's a whole lot more that's in the field, but kind of your crash courses too. We'll talk about understanding the why, which comes into a lot of what several people threw out there in terms of trying to prioritize features and things like that. And then I'll wrap up. So just a quick note about myself. I am a classically trained computer science, computer scientist from Georgia Tech. After my time at Tech, spent some time at CareerBuilder.com in their product management group, in particular on the international platform. That's kind of a topic for another day. If anyone's going through an internationalization project, happy to talk to you about that and kind of share tales from the trenches, if you will. And then after that, I went on to be the technical co-founder of Patientco. Kind of my fun fact, just a bit about me, trying to share some of my personal life. Really, I'm a travel junkie, so I've been to, at this point, over 30 countries. So if I'm not working, odds are I'm probably traveling. Just a quick note about Patientco. So Patientco, again, as I mentioned, we are a 50-person growing startup here in Atlanta. We're in the healthcare IT space, and we really help hospitals and doctor's offices simplify their patient billing. So if you've ever gotten a confusing healthcare bill or had trouble paying that bill, that's really the problem we solve, and we have a lot of fun doing it. We were named on the Inc. 500 list of fastest growing companies, and we've been going for about 7 years now, and like I said, have about 50 employees. So if you're interested in making a career change at any point in time, definitely check us out. We're hiring pretty aggressively now at patientcolife.com. That's our kind of dedicated site. So let's kind of jump into the meat of the presentation. Really differentiating between the development and a product management mindset. And I think, in my experience, there really are two pretty distinct mindsets. When I've got my development hat on and I'm in the zone being a developer, I kind of push aside a lot of those product management things. And vice versa, if I'm kind of thinking like a product manager, I got to remind myself that even though I've been developing for a long time, I've really got to think about things more from a product management perspective. And so I think it's important to kind of differentiate that. Why? When you learn to think like a product manager, you really can increase your impact. It's a much more holistic way of thinking. You know, when you're a developer, you're solving kind of a very specific problem. As a product manager, you're kind of looking at the world as a whole. Second, reduce wasted development effort. Find that a lot of times development teams want to go in and solve problems. They're going to build a lot of things, and it turns out that not all the things that got built might have been needed. And so how can you identify some of those traps earlier on, even when you're assigned a development ticket? We're going to get into that. Certainly expanding scope of influence. So from a career aspirations perspective, if you're looking to, you know, get out of day-to-day development or want a career where you can really leverage your technical background, but still have some different types of influence within an organization, I found that product management is a great way to do that. And I think most importantly, something near and dear to my heart is making the product better. I truly believe that when a development team starts to pull in some of these product management type thinking, it's actually going to improve the product. Even if you're not the dedicated product manager or you're not, you have another group that's doing it, when you start to think like some of these, start to think through some of these different things as a product manager, the product itself actually gets better. And that's something we spend a lot of time with at Patientco with our entire development team, is bringing in some of these type of concepts. So the way I differentiate the development mindset versus a product management mindset, it's really questions. So from a development perspective, the main question you're answering is, how should a product be built, right? You're handed a set of business requirements or a set of functional requirements.